Thanks. I'm not trying to sell them after the picture, eh?
We hope you do, but I doubt very much.
That they will God's eternal peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our Heavenly Father, we turn to you in our need, as generations before us have also turned to you in our need, and we pray with confidence, because we pray in the name of Jesus, our Lord, forever and ever. Tonight, as we celebrate the 75th anniversary of the establishment of this community of faith, we have a wonderful opportunity to ask ourselves, what is a parish? What is a parish intended to be? When this parish was established 75 years ago, what was the intention of the founders? What should be our intention today? What should we be handing on to the future? Well, the best place, I think, to look for the answer to that question is found in our scripture readings this evening, which Father Bill Houlihan has chosen, and chosen very wisely. Because our scripture readings this evening remind us of three marks or three characteristics of what a parish should be. And as I reflected on the readings, I began to believe that a parish should be, first of all, a school of wisdom. It should be a school of selfless love. And it should be a school of prayer and worship. I happened to notice this morning when I was looking at news reports of the Holy Father's trip to Ecuador, he talked about the family as the domestic school, where so much about faith and life is learned. In a very similar way, in a parallel way, the parish is also a school where so much about faith and life is learned. In our first reading from the book of Kings, we have Moses addressing the people. And he's addressing the people about the laws and the commandments that God has given them. And he reminds the people, and this is a lesson that we need to learn today, that the law of God, that the commandments of God, were never and are never intended to restrict our liberty or our freedom. They're not meant to set a fence around us, to hem us in. But instead, the laws and the commandments of God are intended to give us a way of life that gives us great freedom to know and worship God, great freedom to know that we are living at peace with one another and with God. Gives us great freedom. There's nothing worse than living a life of uncertainty and doubt. By knowing the commandments of God, we will be free to live a life of fidelity. And that life of fidelity is a life of joy. In our second reading from St. Paul's letter to the Colossians, we hear St. Paul talking about a typical community with its difficulties, but also with its joys. He reminds the people that while the world around them measures success in terms of power and authority, wealth and territory, a Christian community can never measure itself by those same standards. If members of a Christian community are concerned about their own authority or their own territory, that Christian community is doomed. But a Christian community needs to be stand up to serve, who give without counting the cost, who enable others before themselves. It is a school of selfless love. It's where we learn to love one another. And finally, in our gospel this evening, we hear that wonderful passage where Jesus reminds everybody to pray, to seek and you will find, to ask and it will be given to you. The parish is intended to be a school of prayer and worship. But in our gospel, Jesus adds an interesting little example. He talks about a father giving his child an egg or a serpent. And he says, now if you are evil, and I don't think he means that, you know, terribly condemnatory, but he says, if you who are weak and know how to give what is good, how much more your heavenly Father? You see, one of the keys to learning to pray is learning who God is, who God truly is. God is not one from whom we should expect an egg or a serpent. God loves us too much. God is one who wants to give us what is good and good for us. God is one who loves us beyond all our imagining, who is present to us day in and day out. God is one who wants only our happiness and joy and peace. And if we understand that that's who God is, then that shapes how we pray. That shapes what we ask for. That shapes what we expect in prayer. And so tonight, as we celebrate 75 years as a parish community, we celebrate all of those people who have gone before us, priests, religious, and the faithful, who have made this parish a school of wisdom, teaching how to live, a school of selfless love, showing an example of how to live, and a school of prayer, showing how to love God. And we entrust the future to God as well tonight. We ask God to give this generation and every generation to follow the grace to continue to build on the past, that this will be a future parish and school of wisdom, selfless love, and prayer. Fathers.